Hello everyone and welcome back to CLGTart channel. So today I'm gonna show you guys a tutorial to how to paint a Galaxy Night or a Starry Night like this one with Medibang Paint Pro, and this is really easy. Okay, so before I'm starting this tutorial, I will tell you guys the program I'm using is Medibang Paint Pro, and the brush I use will have the sketch will be the little pencil B, and I will use the Cloud 2 brush. You can download it from Medibang for free, and sometimes I will use the airbrush for some soft part, the fill brush to paint some leaf and the grass. Yeah, you maybe will find that I will have some leaf. That's the custom brush that I made, so I'm not listing it here. And let me see if I use another. Oh yeah, I have the sparkle brush to paint the star, the night sky. Okay, so before I'm starting the tutorial, I will sketch a little bit. When you're drawing the want to do something, you must have the sketch. It will be easier for you guys. So the cloud here, you imagine the cloud kind of like this, and it's also affected by the light. So where is the light coming from? That part will have the highlight, and the other part will be the shadow. Okay, that will be like this. And in the galaxy light night, you will see that it kind of like has some part here. It will be like it is shining, and on the cloud around here will work under this. The sketch here, you'll be just something. Maybe you will have the grass here, like the view from the bottom. Look up to the sky. Yeah, like this. And with this, the sketch like this one, you can form the look of the cloud, and we know where you will cast the shadow and where's the light will reach. So this one will be the light, and the other part will be the shadow. Okay, and now I will create a new layer for starting to paint it. I will put the sketch layer, this is layer 1 on the top, so it won't be covered by the layer 2 later. Now we'll pick two colors. First will be the blue for the darker. I will pick around this part, and I change it to click S, so you can swap the color box like this one. And you will pick the purple around this part to make the lightning purple or violet. Yeah. Okay, so then you will choose the gradient tool. Yeah, the gradient tool, and choose the foreground to background subliner, and then you will drag it from the top to the bottom, this one. Okay, kind of like this. Look better now. And then you can see that it will be the shadow from the bottom here, so I will change the type from foreground to transparency here. So I drag it kind of like this. Yeah, a little bit more. Okay, so the next step, you can create a new layer or not, depend your choice. If you're scared to make a mess later, you can create a new layer or just paint on the same layer. Is depend your choice anyway. And I will use the brush that is cloud 2 here. You maybe want to click to the wheel here to change some setting of the brush, like the cloud concentration and the scatter here to change it the look of the cloud. Okay, I won't have the fixed setting for this brush, because you know that depend on how the result I want it to it will appear on the picture. I will change the setting to fit what I intend to do. Okay, and now I will have the dark color right now, and you will see how the cloud brush will work. It's like you will paint the cloud here. Okay, and now you will pick the blue one with the high saturation to create some middle color, kind of like this. Then the purple. Now I turn off the sketch. You can see how it looks. It will be kind of like this one. A little bit shadow around this part. Shadow around here too. You maybe want to click some transition color, like the mix between the dark and the light blue color around here, to have the transition color look like this one. Okay, just have fun with this one and fix it until you have the nice result. And to reduce the time, you see that I will turn off all of those things and I will have the final result kind of like this. Okay, remember you must have the light, and maybe you want to increase the light of the cloud here. Like I will pick really the pale violet around this part here to pan it to make sure there's will be the big light short around here. And then I will create a new layer and put it a lighten. It is just the layer that will increase the shadow rotation of the color and will kind of like confirm where the light shots are coming from. So it's really easy to create a new layer and change blending to lighten, and then you'll pick the color of this one, use the same cloud tool brush, and then draw it around here. Maybe you want to increase the shadow rotation of this one and it will be look kind of shining like this one. And finally you will have the result here after you work a lot. And I create a new layer in here and choose lighten again. This will be the lightning of the star. We'll paint the star like you see. I create a new layer and change to the lighten. Then I will use the sparkle. Where is it? Right here. Sparkle brush and paint the star around here. This star is not the light star, because you know that in the sky you will see some star is not kind of dim and not shiny enough, and some star will be really shiny, so you will mimic that light in that sky. So that's why. And finally you will have the result of this one. You can see that if I increase it to 100%, because at first I pick the color is too light, is not as the star in the background. So that's why if you make a mistake, let me that this one, you can fix that by reduce the opacity of this one around to 20 to 30. That will be make it like the star in the background. Okay, so next you will create a new layer that will be the shiny things. And really easy, right? You will create a new layer in here and choose the blending to add. Next, you will use the airbrush here, a really really soft brush, and pick the color where it will be shiny and star. Really really carefully drag around here for where the points will be appear the light, not the whole thing, like not like this one, just carefully lightly put around here from this part to another part, not the whole picture. You maybe want to increase the light of the color to more brightness, and you will do like this one. You can see how the cloud is glowing, and it will show the effect that you can see that something, the effect that the light is coming from. Okay, so I will go back with the sparkle brush again and pick the light color and then pan it around here kind of like this. Increase and decrease the brush size to make it look more Starry Night like this. Okay, and when you're done this one, you will have the final result like this one. And you can finish this step around here. This will be the final for the Starry Night and for the Galaxy Night. Yeah, but I want to have some background to make it look more beautiful, like you have some perspective in the picture and some details in here. It will make the picture look better. Yeah, so that's why I create a new layer. And it's just normal. You will use the fill brush, this brush here, and pick the dark color, the darkest color. You maybe want to change it to black, it's okay, but I don't really like the pitch black. Just choose the darkest color in the pictures in here and then starting to paint like this one. To paint some grass, the fill color will help you when you paint it, and it will automatically fill the whole thing. Like you draw the outline and it will fill the inside, like this one. I also have some custom made brush for the branch and the leaf to have more detail and reduce time. Okay, kind of like this one, and you can fix that, change the angle, everything, and then you are done this tutorial. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video.